Mortuary and Cremation Services is licensed in Delaware and Maryland with locations in Wilmington and Smyrna. Family-owned House of Wright is prepared to support your family when you need the most. The House of Wright offers funeral pre-planning and personalized services that include cremation, memorial blankets, and veteran services. Our compassionate staff will help you select an affordable package that recognizes and respects the unique life of your loved one. The House of Wright Mortuary, providing comfort and compassion at the right time. 302-762-8448.
Your comforter, God, friend, provider, lover, keeper, my righteousness, my sanctifier. Hallelujah. Oh God, when I come into your presence, I can feel your anointing. Yes, Lord God. Saturates my spirit. Overflows my soul. When I come to your presence. How many feel this anointing tonight?
I can feel your anointing.
Hallelujah.
Like an overflowing fountain.
It's good. Thank you, Jesus. Saturates my spirit now.
Welcome to The Right Moment. I am your host for this evening, Michelle Lockamy, and thanks for tuning in. Today's show is going to be very special, near and dear to my heart. As most of you know, it is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and I am a breast cancer survivor, and I have some wonderful guests here with me, and we're going to talk about some upcoming events and just give you a little bit of information and insight on the wellness of women and information on breast cancer overall. Okay, so we're going to get right into our show. I want to welcome Ms. Desiree Potts, Ms. Tracy Burns, Kalila Hines, and Ms. Tynetta Brown. Ladies, thank you so much coming on today, and thank you for wearing your pink today.
Yes,
I really appreciate it. Before we get started, I do want to make one announcement that I have. There is a, and I hope Abin can get a screenshot of this, there is a wellness conference that's coming up called Every Woman Matters. It's a breast health and wellness conference. This is going to take place on next Saturday, October the 17th, from 8 a.m. to 2:30 p.m. at the John Hammond Medical Center, and that's on the Christiana Hospital campus. I'm just going to leave the number. If you have any questions, concerns, need more information, you can call 1-800-693-CARE. Once again, the number is 1-800-693-CARE, C-A-R-E. And we're going to get right into our show. So once again, ladies, thank you, thank you, thank you for coming. Thank you very much. Miss Desiree, we're going to start with you since you have the most recent or the more recent event coming up.
Yes.
Okay. And you are the
CEO
an organization called Choices.
Yes.
You got to tell the viewers what Choices stands for.
Choices stands for Coalition of Hope, offering inner city empowerment services. And we are a 501c3 nonprofit organization. And our mission is to spread breast cancer awareness and to raise funding for those currently going through treatment, patients and survivors. So we have annual events to assist women with medical bills, spa days, things of that nature. We raise money. And we have an upcoming ball on October 16th, Friday. In which we're honoring you, Michelle. So we're excited about that. The breast cancer ball is just a way to have women who have who are currently going through breast cancer treatment and survivors, giving them the opportunity to share their journey with the general public, just to let women know that it's not a death sentence. Be a health advocate for yourself. And so it's just about the just elevating and promoting women, because you guys are just pillars of strength and courage, and you encourage and inspire us. And it's also important to recognize caregivers because they are just as important to women that are diagnosed with breast cancer.
Very true.
So I'm going to have my board member Tracy is here. So she's also going to expand on what Choices do. We have two major events, and that's a breast cancer walk, which is in April of every year, normally the last Saturday of the month, and then we have our annual breast cancer ball, which is normally in October. Like I said, we're excited about honoring you this year.
I am too, along with the other eight, it's nine of us, right? So it'll be eight honorees?
It's nine honorees.
Tracy, can you tell us how the organization came about, when it started, where'd you get the name from?
Des, I have to help me with the dates, but I got this much. Choices Des came up with. Desiree came up with Choices. Choices started not as a breast cancer awareness organization, but as a mentoring program to speak. And it was started by Desiree Potts and Teresa Powell. And they started how many years ago?
13 years.
And the original purpose was to offer mentoring services to the young people in the city of Chester. Des and Teresa saw a need. So through Choices, they were doing the Miss Chester pageant. It used to be called the Miss Chester pageant. It is now called the
Miss Hollywood Glamour.
Miss Hollywood Glamour pageant. They were also doing millionaire mentoring, millionaire-minded mentoring programs. And it was more so one of giving our youth in Chester options. It's no secret that we've got a lot going on in the city. 5 years ago, Teresa Powell, the co-founder of Choices, was diagnosed with breast cancer. As she was going through treatment, and like a lot of women who are diagnosed with the illness, she was a working mom. She was a working person.
Living her a normal family, life. And,
exactly. Her family counted on her income to keep the household going. And what we found out is that, and Teresa, not like a lot of other people, in order to be able to collect benefits from her employer, she had to go without a paycheck for 30 days. And who can afford to do that? 30 days is paramount to bankruptcy sometimes. So Desiree went on a hunt looking for organizations who would provide Teresa with financial assistance so that she could afford to sit home the 30 days until her short-term disability kicked in. And what we found is that there were plenty of organizations that were offering money towards research, but there was nothing out there that could directly benefit the patient as they were going, undergoing treatment. And ergo came Pink Stiletto Initiatives. And through Pink Stiletto Initiatives, we started raising money. And it was really funny because initially our thought was Teresa. Our thought was Teresa at that point. And then it just expanded. And so with Pink Stiletto Initiatives, we are there. We will pay You know, if it's the electric bill, if it's the gas bill, if it's buying books because your kid just started college mm-hmm. and mom has breast cancer and is undergoing chemo and is too sick to work, it's providing money so that that child gets books that season. Awesome. Or, you know, a mom who is undergoing treatment, mm-hmm. except she's got babies at home mm-hmm. and Christmas comes up.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
what Pink Stiletto initiatives, that's what we raise money to do, to give it directly back to mm-hmm. The survivors, to put, okay. you know, put something. And sometimes, you know, it's just a smile.
Yeah.
It's just
yeah.
a smile. Plenty of money is going to research. And it's not to say that the research is not important.
Right.
However, there are other needs. Right. And we decided through Pink Stiletto Initiatives that we wanted to meet the other needs and bring a smile mm-hmm. to those faces with a kind gesture.
And I can vouch for that. Just having that direct contact. Like you said, even though we know that things are being done, mm-hmm. for research, yeah. money's being donated for research, yeah. but to have that support system, like you said, the mentoring part, to have that support system right there with you, mm-hmm. no matter what else is going on, right. it is. It's very important, and I found that out. Yes. I really did. Yes. I really did.
Yes.
Des, I want you to tell me about how Coalition. Let me get this right.
Choice.
Coalition of Hope offering inner city empowerment service, which is Choices.
Yes.
How did you come up with that?
It was Teresa and I. We just brainstormed, you know, one evening mm-hmm. trying to come up with a name, and we just put our heads together and just wanted something that would encompass many things, mm-hmm. so to speak.
And it does. I think
yes.
it does too.
And it does. So we wanted to empower women, empower children, mm-hmm. empower the community overall.
Okay.
So we definitely wanted a word that had and the word empowerment in
okay.
it, and servicing the inner city youth, the mm-hmm. you know, the disadvantaged youth, that was important too. So that's basically it.
Okay. Now, is there one location or one city? Is Chester? I've heard Tracy mentioned Chester.
Well, because I'm from Chester.
Okay.
So I service that community.
Okay.
But we also, when I was doing the pageant, we had young ladies from Delaware, Cherry
okay.
Hill,
okay.
Sharon Hill, different areas. So. With the Breast Cancer Initiative, it's women who basically live in the tri-state area.
In the tri-state area, that was going to be my next
yes.
question. Okay, so,
so
it's not just Chester,
say.
Not
no.
just in your community.
No.
Okay.
You're not from Chester,
that's
Michelle.
No.
And we
You're,
found
I,
you.
I,
duh. And we found you.
You sure did.
Yes.
You sure did.
Yes.
Well, that's a good thing. That's a good thing. So once again, we have the ball coming up.
Yes.
That
the,
I'm
the
excited
Pink Stiletto,
about.
The
yeah.
It's our fourth annual mm-hmm. breast cancer charity Pink Stiletto Ball.
Okay.
And so we're very excited,
yes.
and we're sold out.
Awesome. I went back to her to say, "Des, I need some more tickets."
No.
She was like, "Oh." I was like, "What? What?" She said, "No more tickets."
Sold
it's very
out.
Exciting.
That's awesome.
Yes.
Oh,
so
it,
that
gets,
blessing,
it does.
Know?
It gets bigger. It gets
bigger,
better.
We're going to
every
be bigger
year.
Next year, right?
Absolutely. It's our fifth year, so we are gearing up right after
definitely,
this
definitely.
Fall.
Definitely. All right. Can you, you want to leave? Actually, you have contact information here. I don't
yes.
know if you want to maybe shout out your contact information
surely.
Before we move on.
Desiree Potts. My number is 610-800-2453. You can also Facebook me at Desiree Potts or Choices Pink Stiletto Initiatives.
And you have an email address. I like your email address.
I have an email address. mypinkstilettos@yahoo.com.
And once again, your position with Choices?
CEO.
CEO and Tracy?
Board member.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. Well, ladies, I really do appreciate you coming on.
Thank you so much.
And getting the word out for Choices.
Yes.
All right.
Thank you so
all right.
much.
And we're going to move on to our next guest. We have with us, Miss Kalila. Why can't I get your name?
Kalila.
Kalila.
It's,
and
that's
it's
perfect.
Easy. It's
that's
very
perfect.
Easy.
That is
Kalila Hines
yes.
and Miss Tynetta Brown.
Yes.
Miss Tynetta Brown is with Delaware Breast Cancer Coalition.
Mm-hmm.
And Miss Kalila Hines is with Women of Wellness.
Yes.
So, Kalila, Tynetta. Welcome.
Thank you so much.
Want to give us a little bit of information about
the
program?
Thank you so much. We're very excited. Women of Wellness is teaming up with Delaware Breast Cancer Coalition to sponsor the Total Women, Total Women's Conference. It's coming up on October 24th. It's right downtown at the Wilmington Library, and it's absolutely free. There are wonderful, wonderful, informative workshops that will be happening. So We have financial fitness, we have breast health, we have nutrition. There'll be an exercise moment as well as stress management. And did I mention it's free? So it's really,
that should be no reason that anybody
can't
come out.
We're excited about the opportunity to educate our community, African American women suffer disproportionately from breast cancer deaths. There's no reason that you should die from breast cancer based on the treatment that is available, but that unfortunately is a problem. 40% die more prevalently than their counterparts. So it's very disheartening. Yeah. And at Women of Wellness, we believe in empowering women. Mm-hmm. So
what would you say, would you know a percentage of women that have actually come to you that are breast cancer survivors? Or
so Women of Wellness really focuses on promoting wellness and transformative health journeys.
Okay.
So we really, I can't say that we've worked with anyone who's had who has had breast cancer
okay.
yet to this point. We've only been Women of Wellness.